We may sign it, we may put it into law, but are we actually ready for it?
The way I would think of it is that the intent, be it the nations or be it the governments, has been shown emphatically by the speed at which the 44 nations are ratifying, the most recent being Nigeria as the largest economy, right? So there is clear intent. Your question is actually, will the intent be backed by action, yes, by commitment? The way I would think of this is twofold. One is, there's an element of inevitability, right? I mean, if global trade is slowing down, then we have to be able to do trade with ourselves, among ourselves, to kind of substitute for that. That's that kind of feeling of inevitability. The other one is slightly more philosophical, which is that the advent of the new technologies, the use of increasing use of mobile, the use of internet as a mechanism to find markets, aids this process. In the, let's say, a decade back, if someone wanted to sell, let's say, flowers out of Kenya, it was easy to find a market in Europe because that was the established market. There were a group of third-party players who knew the source, who knew the suppliers, who knew the buyers, and they would do the connection. We and the global economy did not have the infrastructure and the technology that enabled easy finding of counterparties. Now, the disruptive technologies actually allow for that. This then will enable us to find. So, who knows, maybe the person who is selling flowers out of Kenya might find buyers in South Africa,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And then execute the trade and hence increase. So there's an element of inevitability, but also the use of disruptive technologies makes it easier.
One of the big struggles has certainly been investment, right? So because you need the funding to sort of find a way to sell your goods, to enter these markets. In finding that investment, we find the likes of China certainly making a big sort of play into Africa. Are we fearful about that relationship?
There is public sentiment that does not look kindly at how China has been engaging our markets. Almost at times saying that it is pushing nations into a debt trap. And what I would say is that it's not unfounded. What we saw happening in Sri Lanka, in Pakistan, certainly lends credence to that thought. The way I would like to approach it, though, is that we need to go into this relationship as an equal, as a more informed person. If we did that, which is, we went in knowing fully well why we are borrowing. So if you're borrowing to build infrastructure, we have to make sure that the assets we create will be productive. The other thing that's becoming very apparent is that Chinese have realized that they need to win the hearts and not just talk to the mind. And they have changed their approach to say, rather than being an export-led country, let us look towards increasing imports. So the Chinese have a very specific expo. They did the first expo in November last year, which is called the Chinese International Import Expo, focusing purely on buying from the rest of the world. And that is a masterstroke, because what they're saying is, we want to buy, please come to Shanghai to sell your goods to us, other than commodities. So they're realizing that it's about other economy. And we as nations, we have to seize the opportunity.
WEF Africa 2019, brought to you by Standard Bank 702 and Cape Talk. More at ewn.co.za.